Hi, and welcome back to Data Science in Minutes. I'm Blair, and in this video, we'll be learning about recommender systems. So, what do you think of when you think of recommendations? My friend recommends that I watch Stranger Things, and my sister recommends that I watch Ozark, and my mom recommends that I see this new documentary on planet Earth. Are these recommendations based on what they like or what I like? And what if I want to watch something different that none of those three recommended? Wouldn't it be great if someone just understood me? Well, that's where recommender systems comes in. So what really is a recommender system? A recommender system is really an automated system to filter some entities. These entities can be any products, ads, people, movies, or songs. And we see this from all over on a daily basis, from Amazon to Netflix to Pandora to YouTube to eHarmony. For example, we watch a movie and then later on we get a recommendation for a different movie based on the power of previous viewing history. It could also be a product that we bought and then we get a recommendation for another product based on the previous product viewing or purchase history. And the recommender doesn't work only in what products we are being shown, but also in what order the products are being ranked. So why are recommender systems being built? Businesses are showing us recommendations and relevant content for a couple of reasons. For one, most businesses think they understand their customer, but oftentimes customers can behave much differently than you would think, so it's important to show the users what is relevant to them while also sharing new items they would be interested in. Recommender systems also serves to help us solve the information overload problem and helps us narrow down the set of choices, and for businesses, they get the benefit of selling more relevant items to the user. It is also there to help you, the customer, discover new and interesting things and to help you save time. And from a business perspective, it helps to better understand what the user wants. So, how does it work? Let's say you like cheeseburgers, sans tomatoes. So how does your mom know whether or not you like tomatoes on your burger? She could have asked you specifically if you want tomatoes, or she watched you pick them out every time you order a burger. A recommendation engine works the same way. It will either ask you what you want, or ask if the content was relevant, look at other users with similar behavior, or study your activity. And even if your mom knows you well, maybe a machine learning algorithm knows you better. For example, when we go to Netflix or any other service that relies on recommendations, the first time when we go there, they will ask you what are your taste preferences. And there is a reason for that. Because if they do not know what your taste preferences are at all, it's a cold start problem. They have no idea and they have no profile for you, and they will force you to at least put in something. What movie do you like and so on, because how would they know otherwise? So let's say I place an order through Amazon Prime for bananas. Now I'm being shown a banana slicer in the recommendations to me. This banana slicer has over 5,000 reviews and a 5-star rating. User ratings, number of reviews, and relevancy can play a factor in terms of what is being recommended to me. Another example of this is how YouTube's recommendations work. Videos that have a lot of watch time, engagement, is relevant to the topic I am searching, and is a relevant topic based on my video history will be shown to me. If I watch a trailer for Avengers Endgame, I might be shown a trailer for Iron Man, or funny bloopers from filming the movie, or an interview with some of the actors. These algorithms are so smart that they are able to decide what to show us, and can be scary accurate. It should also be noted that each company might have their own algorithm and way of generating recommendations, and that what one company's method for applying recommendations does not apply to all. In our next video, we will look at the different types of recommendations and how they are applied. Give us a thumbs up if you like this video, leave us a comment about the strangest thing you've been recommended, and what topic you'd like to see covered in less than 5 minutes. For more tutorials, check out tutorials.datasciencedojo.com. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in our next video.